In this video, you will learn how to create Amazon advertising campaigns using Helium 10's advertising tool. My guest is Vince Montero. He's the product manager of this module in Helium 10, and he will show you step by step how to create everything. And if you would like to test and to try to use Helium 10, find the links below this video, also the coupon codes where you can get 10% off lifetime and 50% for the first month. So make sure you use Helium 10 and try how it works, if it fits for you. And now, before you enjoy the conversation, please subscribe below to the YouTube channel of Orange Klik. Click the notification bell as well, because here we talk with different Amazon experts and software providers. Hello, Vince. Nice to have you here. Could you please introduce yourself and what is Helium 10 Ads about?
Sure. Happy to be here. Thank you for having me. My name is Vince Montero. I'm the product manager for Ads by Helium 10. It's our PPC management tool here at Helium 10. And we have a suite of other tools that help sellers, Amazon sellers specifically, do everything from product research to keyword research. And I'm working on the project specifically helping users for PPC management.
Perfect. And today I invited you to help us to understand one part of the Amazon seller's journey. So what you will be sharing with us today?
One part of the journey, if you're doing any kind of PPC at all, is how to launch campaigns. So I wanted to show users really quickly how you can use some of the Helium 10 tools to launch your initial campaigns that you might use for your product launch.
Sounds good. So we're ready. Let's jump to the screen and see how Helium 10 can help with this process.
This is our Helium 10 dashboard. So if users have Helium 10, this is kind of the first screen that they see. It shows, but you can see all the different tools that we have here. I'm at the bottom because Ads is actually still technically in beta. We're supposed to be out of beta at the end of this quarter of 2020. But I wanted to quickly show users keyword research is a big part of launching PPC campaigns. Obviously, you need keywords in order to do that. So I wanted to quickly show an example of, we got some here already. So I'm just going to look for men's sunglasses, for example. So Magnet will actually do, if you've done a search before for the same thing, it'll actually save it for you, which is great. But it'll actually show you details that are relevant to men's sunglasses, and it breaks them down into different kind of scores. And each one has a explanation of why we're ranking them this way. But a lot of our users sort by search volume, or they sort by maybe competitors in the space for these different keywords. So we give a lot of filters for users to really drill down into the exact keywords that they want to maybe test initially. And we also give different products that are relevant to this keyword here that you can then click on in our other tool called CEREBRO. And that basically looks at an ASIN level, which products are showing on page one, what keywords that they are using to get there. So you can enter a few different ASINs if you want to do a comparison between a few different products. I just did one for the sake of doing an example, but this will generally let you know different keywords that are relevant to that particular product that we just entered. So between using Magnet and CEREBRO, you can really do a solid list of potential keywords that you can use to then use for PPC. And you would basically just export that over maybe to a CSV or an Excel file. And then you would use that in creating your campaign. Now within Amazon advertising, when you're logged in, you basically can create a campaign by clicking on this button. And it gives you a couple of different options here. And each option, depending on if you're brand registered or not, new sellers will only see sponsored products. You won't see sponsored brands or sponsored display. But sponsored products is the basic ad unit that you do want to make. It's the one that appears under the search results, right? So it is the one that you really want to start with when you're building your campaigns. So there's a lot of different parameters here. I won't go into each one, but you know, your basics of your campaign name, if you're going to put it in a portfolio, your budget, what kind of targeting that you want to do. But the thing I want to note is that basically here, you can only do one campaign at a time in the in Seller Central, which is great. But when you launch a product, you're going to want to do more than one campaign. So this is our ads tool. And what we've done, at least as far as campaign creation, is give you the ability to create three campaigns at once. So it saves you time and a little bit of effort. This is in the ad manager section, which is basically similar to the campaign manager in Seller Central. You would just click a campaign, add campaign button. You can see the sponsor product option or sponsor brands option. But again, we were just looking at sponsored products in Seller Central and very similar parameters, right? So you're going to do your name, you're going to enter the SKUs that you want to sell. But the major difference is that we build three campaigns at once, right? And that is because we recommend that when you're launching a product, especially, that you at least have an auto campaign, a research campaign, and a proven campaign. And what I mean by that, auto campaign is basically letting Amazon do the PPC for you. That's letting Amazon connect the search terms that users are entering into the search bar to the keywords or to your product. Research, this is a manual campaign. This is where you would go ahead and you would enter keywords here. And again, this would be pulled from the list that you potentially just saved from Magnet or Cerebro that we just went through. So that's where you would enter the words here. And anything that you do in our builder, you can actually see on the right-hand side as well. So the research campaign, why we suggest this is because you really should have some broad keywords that Amazon will then match search terms for. So you've got broad match keywords, phrase match keywords, and exact match keywords. Broad match keywords that you use will secure more search terms from Amazon to link to those keywords. So that's why it's called a research campaign, because what we're really looking for is additional search terms to the keywords that we're going to enter in this field. The proven campaign is there for keywords that maybe you've already tested before that you know have converted. If you do not have keywords that you know have converted, what we suggest is you just put your brand name keywords here. So keywords that you know are super relevant to your product, obviously, because it's the name of your product. You would put that here. So you do want to fill out all three campaigns. And you, again, you give each a budget, a cost target, a default bid. And we build these in what we call a campaign structure. And once that's done, once these three campaigns are built, we have additional rules here that users enter that will guide us in providing new keyword rules and negative keyword rules to the user. So from the auto campaign, we will do the manual search of looking for search terms that have converted for you that maybe you want to then target as a manual keyword. We'll make it a suggestion to move it here into the research campaign. Same thing for the research campaign. If we find from those broad keywords that we entered, if we find some search terms that have converted well, we're going to suggest that you move them to your proven campaign as an exact match keyword. So the whole goal of this structure is to move keywords that have performed or converted into this final campaign here that you can then really focus on and budget more accordingly and then really scale. So that's the main difference between creating a campaign in our tool versus creating a campaign using the Seller Central structure. The other major benefit of just simply being able to do the three campaigns at once is obviously the suggestions that I mentioned. So suggestions are an area of ads that will provide you, just as the name implies, suggestions on not only keywords themselves, but it'll also give you those suggestions on new keywords and negative keywords. Right now, new keyword suggestions and negative keyword suggestions are only for campaigns built in ads. So that process that I just showed you on that campaign page, that's going to be changing soon. So hopefully we'll be able to have new keywords and negative keywords for campaigns that have been uploaded or pulled into ads and ones that are pre-existing. For the bid suggestions, however, every campaign keyword that you have that's currently active, if you're already doing PPC, we're going to show you bid suggestions for that. So no matter if you've built the campaign and ads or not, we're going to show you keyword bid suggestions. And that's, I don't know how deep you want me to go into that, but we do suggestions based on a lot of different parameters. We have our own algorithm that looks at everything from impressions to CTR, obviously the ACOS goal that the user has entered. And what we're trying to do with these suggestions is basically get the keyword to be closer to this target goal, right, that the user has entered. So obviously, if you see ACOSs that are above this target, this one's 37% almost, and the target's 20, obviously the suggestion is going to be to decrease that keyword bid so that you can get closer to that target goal of 20%.
Can we automate the activation of these suggestions?
Yeah, exactly. So that's another thing that I was going to mention. If you like the suggestions that we're providing to you, maybe you've applied some of these suggestions, which you can do either individually or you can apply, the whole thing per page. So if you can see that it's actually really working well for you, a lot of our users have asked for this portion to be automated. So that is done in the ad manager, and maybe you saw the automate column here. So as soon as the user does turn on the automate column, you can see it says keyword bid changes will occur automatically within 24 hours of activating. So that's a new feature, actually. We just launched at the end of June when we released to our Diamond plan. So it might be worth noting at this point that this this tool ads is currently only available to our Diamond plan. It's Diamond and Elite. That is our $197 plan and up. We do have a plan below this called Platinum for $97 only, but that ads is currently not available for that level.
Thank you very much, Vince. It was a pleasure to see how Helium 10's advertising platform and module works. And to those who are watching, you are welcome to test Helium 10. You will find links below and discount codes. And I believe that Helium 10 has a trial for a few days. And Vince, if someone has questions about how your module is functioning, what's the best way to, the advertising module, what's the best way to get in touch with you or your team?
The best way to get more information on ads itself is just to go to helium10.com /tools/ads. If that's difficult to remember, you can just basically click on our marketing area within helium10.com and you'll see ads come up as an option.
Perfect. Thank you very much and good luck in your business. Bye-bye. I hope this video was useful, and if you would like to test and try Helium 10, check the links below. Also, you'll find the discount codes, and also you are welcome to watch the next video where we talk about Helium 10. Yeah, click or watch or stay here. I wanted to say you can look at me. All right, bye-bye. Good luck in your business.